A great way to explain visual concepts is to use, well, visuals. I'll show you how to use your iPad to do exactly that. I believe it's an interesting way to have your written text and drawing show up overlaid on top of your video. That way, you're in the frame and what you're trying to show is in the frame at the same time. And instead of some NPC random, you know, dark background or a solid color background, you have you in the background talking. So it looks almost magical, like the text just shows up. You got a little taste of it at the beginning, so I'm gonna walk you through how to do it. You're gonna need three things. You're going to need your laptop with some video editing software. You're gonna need your iPad and you're gonna need a camera. So once you have those set up, I'll show you what to do. So basics first, you need to have your camera rolling. Then you need to be on your iPad and open the Notes app. So when you switch over to your iPad, it's best to have it be in dark mode or dark theme mode. Basically in the Notes app, if you have a black background, it'll look a lot better. You can have it the other way around also, where you have a white background with black text on it, but it just won't look as good. I'll tell you why a little later. So just put your iPad in dark mode if not already. Then just start a new note, put it in full screen and start your screen recording. Your screen recording can be started from the control center, top right, scroll down. If you don't see this icon, you'll have to turn it on from your settings. A pro tip, you can do this if you want, it just makes your job a little easier. You can long press on the screen recording button and turn the microphone on. What this does is it lets you sync up the audio from your camera and your screen recording from your iPad. It just makes it a little easier. So if you're talking while you're writing, just you don't have to figure out what goes where. You can just sync up the audio and delete the one from your screen recording, because in all possibility, the one from your camera is gonna be better. So let's say I want some text on the screen. What we can do is start the screen recording and it's started now. Just go onto your iPad and start writing whatever you want. So I'm gonna write Pirated Sardar, that is the name of my channel, or PS. See, now it was kind of live. You might be able to hear the pencil also, which gives it another layer on top of it. This sounds nice, it sounds authentic. Now on the top right, you'll see the screen recording button highlighted in red. Tap on it, stop the screen recording, you're good. Now what I want you to do is export the video from your camera and your iPad onto your laptop, and then I'm gonna show you how to combine both of them together. Okay, so I've got the footage from my camera right there, and then from the screen recording. So what you wanna do is pull this onto the timeline, pull the screen recording onto the timeline. I started the screen recording a tad bit later, I believe. See, now I'm gonna unmute. You can see that these waveforms match. You can kind of zoom in and match them up. So your camera quality, your camera audio quality is going to be a lot cleaner usually. So once it's synced up, just play it together and you'll know if it's synced up.
Just go onto your iPad and start writing whatever you want. So I'm going to write.
So it is synced up. Now what you want to do, okay. What you want to do is unlink the clips from your screen recording and delete the audio from it. That's it. That is good to go. Now you can start, you can actually link these three things together. I won't, this is just my preference. You can if you want to. It'll keep it synced up. I'm just not going to move it around in a way where it's going to get messed up. I know. So up to you. So let's just go through it.
Recording and it started now.
Okay, so you can see the iPad recording is kind of big and chunky in the middle. What you want to do is go under Video, Transform. Make sure your inspector is on. So just press on Inspector under Video, Transform. You can zoom in and you can make sure, just go to the end of your clip. Make sure all the text that's supposed to show up, none of it gets cut out. If it does, you can position it a little higher using your y-axis, or if left or right is getting cut out, x-axis. This is one thing you need to be aware of when you're writing on your iPad. Write within some margins because you will have to zoom in, so there will be a border that gets cut off. So as you can see, still you can't see my video. So what you want to do is go into So open your open effects, search 3D gear, drag this onto the clip, the screen recording clip, and just go over it. Go towards the end, that's usually better. And you'll be by default on transform. Click, go to open FX overlay, and then select a part of the background, and the other stuff just goes away. So basically what's happening is you're selecting a background color that you don't want anymore. So it's usually done for green screen. You can do it for any other color. Just zoom out a little bit. So you can see that the text is still kind of hard to see. So what you can do is just see where the clip starts. So you can cut your talking head video there and at the end. Go back to open effects. Look for box blur and you can get it on top of your talking head. See, it's a little easier to read, but it's still not quite there. So what you can do is take the screen recording clip, move it one track up, go under titles, generators, and a solid color. You can get a black solid color, span it for the entirety of it. Now, essentially what's happening is there's your video clip. On top of that, there's the black image clip, the solid color. And on top of that, you have your screen recording. So if you go towards the end, you'll see the black screen, and then on top of that, there's still the text. What you want to do is select your solid color, go under Inspector Video, go down, and under Composite, you can see the opacity. You can play with it, go a little lower on it. So if you compare it to later on, it's a quite well-lit scene, but here it's blurred out and it looks like it's a little darker. So the black image is kind of like it's semi-transparent and it's letting you see what's behind, but it's not pulling focus away from the text or any drawing. So let's just play it once and you can see how it looks now.
What we can do is start the screen recording and it started now. Just go onto your iPad and start writing whatever you want. So I'm gonna write Pirated Sardar, that is the name of my channel, or PS. See, now it was kind of live. You might be able to hear the pencil also, which gives it another layer on top of it. This sounds nice, it sounds authentic.
Now let's say for just a split second here, you want to have the clip of you talking come back, but you can play around and just, I'll show you how to do it. So if you just play around here and get rid of this and this. So from this point on, you just have everything back because the text stays on a lot longer than, let's say, I intend for it to. So
nice. It sounds authentic. Now go on the top right, you'll see the...
See, it's a lot better. However you want to play around, you can have the text show up, go away, you can have bits and parts of it cut out. You have to play around with bits and parts of it depending on what you want. Now I'll tell you why you shouldn't use your iPad in light mode. So you see right here, if the text was in black, what would happen is you'd have to put a white solid color in the middle. It's gonna be too bright. Basically, you're overexposing the scene and the text is in black. It's not a pretty look. Here's an example of it on the screen. You can see it doesn't look as good. So it's always better to have the screen recording with a black background, white text, easier to see. And again, in your video editing, you can have a black image in the middle. Hope this was helpful. If you want to see more DaVinci Resolve tutorials, let me know. I've also dabbled in Filmora and Final Cut Pro if you want to see those as well. That's it for now. See you in the next one. PS out.